And bye-bye guy everyone hates. Peace. Goodbye, little cherub.
By confronting
Goodbye.
The past, we learn to face the future.
Well, we got something. It just cost us, you know, our DPS character. Over-encumbered. In what way? Do we have... Oh, we probably just have too much food or crap or... You know, people can... Oh, no, they can't pick up anything. Oh, I've got trinkets, though, so I can just equip trinkets. There we go. Are we still too encumbered? We're five items over. Right, you know what? That's actually significant. I think the main thing I've learned is I am required to use every single one of these in items whenever I get the chance. Because they're just kind of just taking up inventory slots, space, you know? In addition, I definitely need to hit as many of these things as possible. Because I'm pretty sure that's what's giving me the occasional healing. And stuff. Alright, well.
Rest now for a time.
The party reached the Vestal Secret. Audrey and the Parathius became more unfriendly. Confront complete. Parthius gained a quirk. Parthius gained a quirk. The loathing howls. Plus 25% drain, flame drain. Plus 20% enemy advantage. All right. At least I can actually just repick my target while going through places. So, goal, fight no more than three road battles. Visit at least three assistance encounters. It also looks
Your
like the mission
is
technically
if it is to carry you where
optional,
you must go.
Which is kind of cool. The reading material here is questionable and undeniably compelling. 25% chance to heal.
Precious relics remind us of a time
well,
before the end.
Should probably do this so that people can actually potentially like each other a bit more. Then eat. Eat. Keep eating. I don't think you quite realize how much food we have available to us. Eat. I don't care if we get negative 10% disease resistance. Amateur armorsmith, 5% chance to gain guard. Cool. Bloodthirsty. Huh. Traits are a lot more active, I feel, as well. You know, as much as I would really love to keep going right now, because I... we're kind of fucked now. It is very simply put, we are fucked now. Can I upgrade it multiple times? No, I can only upgrade each skill once. So that means the length of this journey isn't actually that big. You know what? We're more than likely not going to survive very much longer because there's only three of us now. But let's keep going. The sprawl. You know what? I just realized I didn't actually set the destination properly.
Behold,
so
the great cities of man, ruined and aflame.
Wow, there's a lot of assistance encounters here. You guys want to go for a heal? Fine, we'll go for a heal. Just to make you happy. Oh, not a heal, a be friendly to people thing. Wow, What happened to the goddamn city? You know what'd be really cool? Is if for this game, they... Well, I suppose they can't really. I was gonna say if they took some of the mod inspiration. So like, you know the rat mod that I always use, the rat encounter I often had in Darkest Dungeon. That would be an interesting thing, but... What do you want to do? We can trade with the little we have. Oh yeah, I didn't buy any items, did I? I really have to give credit to the gruesome appearance here. Relationship tested. Oh, goody! They're resentful now. I hate every single one of you. I kinda hope you all die, so I can level up and potentially earn a new... And potentially earn a new type of character. Hastened enemies. Oh, goody. Right, who wants to bloody... Feel the burn. Combo. Oh, that's what that symbol means. Triggers additional skill effects when targeted. Huh. Jesus Christ. Okay, man-at-arms. Someone doesn't want to die today. Why are you dazed? Oh, because you're resentful. Of course. And then you're blind because of your leprosy.
Lethality writ large.
Wow, nice crit. I would say it's too easy to become stressed, but that's what Darkest Dungeon tends to be about. It being too easy to get stressed. Although this Lost in Space trait seems really kind of interesting with the way it works. Alright, you're dead, and now you're dead. Alright! You can get the killing blows yourselves then, I guess. I like your decor, town. It's relatively interesting, isn't it? The Burning Pile. Oh, hello there. Oh, you guys look interesting. Fanatics! Crush all who impede. We can smite them. What's a few relics to save bloodshed? No, I agree with the smite. I still want to know what happened to the religious characters. So you spawn with dodge and you spawn with block plus. Sacrificial. Okay. Well, they're not exactly very blight resistance, I say, when he gets the 1 in 20 chance to avoid it.
End.
Immolationist. Oh, let me guess, you're burning. Yes, because Darkest Dungeon just had to add another status effect, didn't it? Oh, and then we're bleeding. Flame spreads. I'm going to guess you're gonna like blow up if you get to the front. Meaning I need to stop that from happening.
Mistimed as directed.
Fire rises. Added strength. Please tell me it's literally what I just said. The fire spreads, you move forward. Good. Do crap all while I swish the... Oh, screw that weak bullcrap! Alright, that's dead, this isn't. But we are also in desperate need of a heal. You got 4 HP, you've got 9, but you're at the front.
A little help impeccably timed.
I gotta play the 50-50. Booyah! Let's go! Funeral pyre. Oh, don't be an absolute ass. Look, we know, both know you are dead this next turn. Yeah, because you've got, what, 4 blight and you've got 2 HP. You are dead. Go screw yourself. But this flare. Oh, nice hit and nice dodge there, little lady. Blinding gas. Give it daze and blind.
The smallest variable can make all the difference.
So that thing doesn't produce a corpse. Makes perfect sense. And you were blind, so go screw yourself. Perfect. Well, you seem happy to stand behind me. Yeah, that's kind of your job, Mr. Man-at-Arms, if you hadn't realized. Why do you have a death door resistance?
Another impediment, cleared with impunity.
Oh, you're taking a lot of status effects now. Yeah, that needs a heal. Block plus. Oh, the amateur metalsmith has a 25% chance to give you block plus. Oh, that's kind of different. Hit it, it's now dead. We win. Well done, guys. Meltdown. You lost all your friendship and you lost about, like, a bunch of health. Main point is we can't die to stress anymore. I'm sorry, what is your blight resistance? Isn't it like 5%? Oh, it's 40%. You know what? That's a little worse, I suppose. Oh, she might be dead now.
Steady yourself.
If it wasn't obvious, I'm actually trying to die at this point. Boxing gloves. Wow, that's the first time it's propped.
Another impediment. Cleared with impunity.
Glorious. Another easy encounter. We're definitely gonna die to the point we reach the next guardian, aren't we? Another burning pile of fanatics. Oh, and they're not even giving me a choice. A pathogenic approach will assure our victory. You know what? You're the only one which has extra stuff attached, so you know what? Sure, why not? Let's see, what do you do? Does that mean you can make things start with blight, or...? Debuff. Minus blight resistance. Yeah, I mean, that's kind of important. Eyes closed. I'm guessing that makes me blind. Yep. I've noticed that the lowest resistance to everything that everyone has is debuff. And I'm beginning to understand as to why it is the lowest, too. Because it is clearly the most needed. Ow. Why'd you get 2 attacks? Accelerants. On hit, apply fire and speed. Okay.
A breakthrough.
Hardly impressive. Really? Really? Can't you guys just get along? Oh, bloody hooray. Well, that's one corpse. Jawbreaker. Ow. Again, though, why are you getting two turns? At last, you get your due. If you want her to get her due, just stop defending her. Did you just heal the corpse? Okay, now you can say fuck you. Burning Aegis. I don't like how you're the defender. Now you apply three burning on hit. Oh goody. You know what? Screw it. Let's blight this thing to death. Well, that's now dead. Is there a way I can delay or something? I guess I can guard you instead. Tell me, are you gonna get blighted again when you do your accelerant at the beginning of the round? No. No, you're not. But I'm gonna take a lot of burn damage right now, because, yeah. You think you're better than me? Yes! I do actually think he's better than you. Mostly because he doesn't weaken his allies! Goodbye. That one should have been mine. No, it really shouldn't have been.
Experience, however.
Oh yeah, another encounter right ahead of me. Oh yeah, and another mini encounter. Okay, you know what? I said I wanted to die, and I'm very near it. Congratulations, you're on death's door. Let's see if you manage to survive.
Variable can make all the difference.
It's debatable if you'll survive now.
Self-reliance is a rare and wonderful thing.
Then again, you can heal yourself, so I guess you don't have to worry too much about it. Man, the Grave Robber really is just kind of self-sufficient. Impervious enemies. Plus 40% stun resist. Okay, that's a thing, I guess. Well, let's get that blinding gas active. Wait, does stun not exist in this? Oh wait, yes it does. We've been stunned. The fire rises. What are you doing to him? Oh, strength. That's bad. Alright, let's see this defender in action. 4 damage. You know what? Good enough. Two damage. Also fine. That's dead. Brilliant. We are so screwed. Hooray for death's door, yay! You've got 1 HP left. And that thing's now on death's door, excellent. I like the death's door animation, the fact where they actually look like they're about to keel over.
Persistence will overcome even the greatest of threats.
Alright, let's see if they can resist the fire for a few rounds. Dying to fire for a couple of rounds, you know? Ah, you have a meltdown, do you? Oh, goody.
Let us hope they find
peace. Oh, they didn't get any. any of that thing I just mentioned. Wow, 75% chance, 75% chance much? Oh, now you're on death's door. Let me guess, we're about to die to burning. All of us, right? Oh, you lived! What's your death's door resistance now? Still 70. How do you two still hate each other when you're about to die? What's wrong with the pair of you?
Dragged back from the brink.
Alright, you're not gonna kill us today. Look, there may only be two of us, and they may be kinda useless by together. But, you know. Yeah.
Once again, teetering on that terrible precipice.
Let me guess, you now die to the burn. Do you? Do you? No, you don't! Bleed her bloody ass! Oh yeah, she's got a death door chance, doesn't she? Well done, the pair of you! Really? You still got that damn mentality?
By confronting the path, this is no place for decent folk.
Look, as much as I like this, and you can expect me to play more of this is actually really fun. We are so bloody pecked now. But that's on purpose as well, because I'm trying to die now. To be fair, I shouldn't have actually used the man-at-arms to guard if I was trying to die as much as I say I was.
Recovered from the
Here we are at the academic study, and I believe this lets us...
emanates an antediluvian power.
Oh, it gives us something. This meddling could destroy us. You know what? I like you. What's this? Question mark and whatever
in
that
this
is.
World, wealth is worthless
Item.
Without purpose.
We got almost nothing from that. Oh, but there's a hero's shrine in front of us. I'm interested about the hero's shrine. Mostly because I'm interested whether it's between, if it works between runs. But that doesn't matter because we're now fucked.
A slow dissection. An unavoidable end.
Oh, nice crit, Mr. Man-at-Arms! You might just let us live after all! Oh, I'm sorry, did you ignite yourself? Were you expecting to live? Oh, don't melt down, you useless little... envious! Oh, they're envious of each other now! Oh, I'm so sorry!
Let us hope.
Now there's no one to be envious of.
Excellent work.
I mean, you don't have a whatamacallit resistance, do you? No. That means you're dead.
Miscalculation, perhaps.
Because you still got blight on you. So, bye-bye. Well,
an inkling of potency still
I'm pretty sure I said something about relic. Him being the last man standing, and... well, he is, so... Well, Mr. Man-at-Arms, let's continue your story. Shrine of Reflection. Let's see your story, Mr. Man-at-Arms.
Man-at-Arms. Chapter 1. A premature promotion.
Okay. What's going on with that?
The politics of a military career are perhaps as treacherous as war itself.
Probably.
Though untested in combat, his acumen for advancement was unmatched.
Really?
Through a dubious campaign of influence and intimidation, he had at last claimed a coveted command.
Oh.
He was eager to bask in the glory of the victories that were sure to come.
Ooh. So he was a... So he's like a nobleman. I didn't realize the Man-at-Arms was a nobleman. Bellow. Remove riposte minus 3 speed. And it targets everything. That's pretty cool. I like that. The desperate few. Okay, Mr. Man-at-Arms, what do you want to do? Physical labor can relieve our worries for a while. Tuckered out.
Abandoned or
oh,
forgotten.
So that's what that symbol means. Now. You get a random perk of some sort. What's tuckered out? Minus 50, if below 50% damage, minus 10%, you are fucked. Come on, let's just get this over with already. No, you're not gonna make it. What gave it away? The fact you're the last man standing? The fact you just had a meltdown and lost all your health? Seriously, what gave it away? I can't tell. Academic study, what do you want to do? You want to leave. You know what? I don't blame you. Let's go. Alright, which way do you want to go? Because, you know what? Screw it. No. Oh, I've already messed up. I figured we might as well go for the... Stuck in the court, the coach with the likes of you. Baratheon, who are you talking to? You're the last man standing. Which isn't a surprise, because you're the tank. And they somehow... I think they've improved your damage. But... What do you want to do this time? Let's push them out of the mud.
An unexpected find.
You're a good man, Baratheon. Baristan, sorry. I'm not even close to the right name. But tell me, do you think you can actually defeat the Guardian? Or do you think this will be a worthy foe for you to finally die against? Because I'm thinking it's the second option. Alright, Baratheon. You are, without a doubt, fucked. But try and take a few of them with you, okay? Or at least one of them with you. And preferably don't be blinded. That's kind of not how you get one to die. I kind of want to die to this thing, because I want to see what happens when it inevitably explodes. Baristan, you probably want to crit the next attack, you know? Well, it's too late now. Any chance you had of killing that guy is now gone. Baristan, are you ready to go out in a blaze of glory? I'm not sure how much glory. Personally, I wouldn't say much glory, but are you ready to go out in a form of death, at least? All right, let's see it blow up. Yeah, I was expecting more damage than that.
Suffering begins.
You can't bear another moment. Well, you still attack, but you're dazed, so... Yeah.
Let us hope they
bye-bye, Baristan.
The Odyssey strengthens you.
Does it?
Are you shaken? There is so much worse in store.
Alright, so I gained 4 levels. Unlocked reward. Hellion. Nice. I can't wait to see it.
Prevail.
Calming incense. Clotting powders. Stale bread. Apples and cheese. Flapjacks. And then a bunch of trinkets. Jester only. Leper only. Oh wow, we can unlock new quirks. That's interesting. Well. Oh, so we just go straight back into a new game when we fail.
While the flame
well, you know what?
Burns.
You know what, everyone?
Hope.
I'm all out of time for today's episode. Way out of time. So what can I say other than thank you all for joining me today? I have been your host, the Parafox Archangel. The English gentleman of the internet, and I hope to see you all again next time. But I'm afraid that until then, it is time for me to bid thee all farewell, good day, and finally, good night.